Merry Christmas, everyone. I'm Gord Martineau, and for the past 14 years, we've had the privilege of airing on City News the stories of children from around the world who come here to Sick Kids Hospital for their life-saving surgeries, all because of your generous support of the Herbie Fund.
Until I came here, I didn't sleep for a long time.
Cisse Sime is here in Toronto with his four-year-old son from Addis Ababa, Ethiopia.
Almost done. Halfway.
It was just a year ago that his family learned that little Adriel had a life-threatening heart problem.
Why couldn't he get the help that he needs in Addis?
I think they cannot do it in the hospital over there. On the TV, CCTV, I saw some of they helping a lot of people from all over the world. And they say, let me try. And I was so happy for them.
Okay, which one of you four is the patient? Adriel? Pleased to meet you. So did you understand what they told you about your son's heart?
Yeah.
What your child has is a defect in the upper chamber. We take pericardium, which is a normal outer lining of the heart, and we use that as part of the repair.
The formula for success for saving a child with a life-threatening medical condition is pretty simple. We make a donation to the Herbie Fund, and the rest is taken care of by the best pediatric surgeons in the world here at Sick Kids Hospital in Toronto. It's surgery day, which is always a nerve-wracking experience for parents.
Hey, mister. It's okay.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that smile.
All right, let's go.
All right.
Herbie Fund kids like Adriel are special. They are here in Canada as visitors, so their life-saving procedures can only happen when there is a vacancy in one of the operating rooms. The excellent pediatric surgeons donate their time and skills to save these children.
Four-year-old Adriel Sime from Ethiopia has two heart defects. Both threaten his life, but both will be corrected through surgery today here at the Hospital for Sick Children, made possible by you and your donations to the Herbie Fund.
So normally they connect to the left side of the heart, but here they're connected aberrantly into the right superior vena cava.
This can be done, you know, with one operation, so we won't need multiple operations, so it's an ideal situation for the family.
So they've basically completed most of the repairs, and now an echocardiogram is being performed to ensure the repairs are accurate. And after that, they'll close them up and it's all done.
Good news.
Thank you.
Your son's doing fine.
Thank you.
With any luck, there'll be no further surgery required. And so that's very good news.
Thank you. So I just need to listen to your heart.
6 years ago, another Herbie kid, Richard Galak, underwent the same surgery as Adriel.
I don't know what to do that time, so I just keep on praying that everything went well.
So there's no way it's going to close on its own or anything like that. It needed to be done.
6 years later, this very grateful family made the long trip to Canada to say thank you.
Can I hug you?
Yes, souvenir.
That's great. That's your
The sad truth is that I see patients when they're in trouble, and so when they get through surgery and then they have a good long healthy future, I unfortunately don't often see that. Yeah. And so it's nice.
Thank you to all who keep on donating. Thank you so much from my family. Thank you.
Hey, you feel good?
Yes.
It's only been a week, but already Adriel looks healthy and is feeling great.
So 100%, you can't get higher than that. So you'll have to remind him to sort of take it easy a bit, no hanging from monkey bars or climbing trees, those kinds of things. Everything looks great. There's no signs of infection or anything.
Adriel gets a final checkup and all is well. Soon they'll head home to Ethiopia to start a brand new chapter in their lives.
Thank you, Canada. I love you.
Tomorrow we'll meet baby Malik from Nairobi, Kenya, and follow Malik and his mom, Chantal, through a hugely complex total reconstruction of his skull. If you'd like to help these kids, please donate online, herbiefund.com.